All right, hey, we're making something really delicious out here today, and your kids are gonna love it. It's nutritious as well, much better than opening those things that are all processed, you know what I'm talking about. Number of sweet treats that we can pack in our kids' lunch, and here is a very good, wholesome way to do it at home. Joining us here is Laurel Melcher. She is a pastry chef and bakery manager for a Perigary restaurant group, and you've got a really fun, easy, and it smells fantastic out here.
Oh,
what are we doing?
Thank you. We've got some oatmeal raisin cookies going, and I know this is the most basic lunchbox cookie,
right,
but I think the version we do is really amazing. Let me just walk you through real quick.
Yeah, please
how
do.
We mix it. We've got some butter, not too much butter. You know, we're trying to keep them maybe a little bit healthy.
Do you want it kind of room temperature?
Yes, you absolutely want room temperature. Nice and soft. I like to use a combination of granulated sugar.
Okay.
Oh, excuse me.
And just throw in a little ceramic for some crunch.
Bowl in there sometimes.
All right, we got brown sugar.
And we got some brown sugar.
Does it matter, light or dark?
I like the light stuff. It gives it a nice soft, gives you a little bit of a softer cookie, a little more brown on it.
Okay.
We're not actually going to mix the whole thing here because that actually takes a little bit. But
you're
cream, butter, and sugar. You're going to add in eggs, vanilla. Get the real stuff, the real vanilla extract.
Is there like a specific, like, do you just buy like the stuff on the top shelf, or can you get like the old like spice brand kind?
Look for the stuff that says 100%. Vanilla extract.
That's what you want to look for.
And it's an alcohol base. It's usually a bourbon base.
Okay. Good to know. Good to know.
And then, you know, we have salt, baking soda, keep the bee out of it.
and some honey. Thanks, bee. Thanks, bee. He's
Bring
like,
honey.
This is my cousin. I'm kidding. Okay, so we have like some white flour.
White flour and oats. You can use a combination of white and whole wheat flour if you want to make it a little healthier.
Mm-hmm.
Twice as many oats as flour here. If you
What if you use just wheat flour? My wife, don't listen kids, uses wheat flour to make chocolate cookies. They have no idea. Could you do that?
Absolutely.
Okay, it wouldn't make the cookie all funky or something.
It would probably maybe be a little thicker and you have a little denser, but
good to know.
You know, and I really like that. So.
Right.
And this has a lot of oats in it. Like I said, twice as many oats. As there's 3 cups of flour, there's 6 cups of oats.
I know there's different kinds of oats. There's like steel cut and the instant Quaker, you know, ready, you know, before you turn the gas on. But there's a certain kind of oat you like to use in this?
I like to use rolled oats.
Okay.
What are often called old-fashioned oats at the grocery store.
We got 30 seconds.
All
right. We're being chit-chatting a little too long. So you take the cookie and you made this kind of cream filling. It's a cream cheese filling in here, right?
Yeah, it has a cream cheese frosting inside. Oh. That one's yours now.
Fantastic.
And we actually sell these at our Cafe Bernardo's.
Oh, so good.
The little cookies.
All right. Well, hey, you know what, Laurel? You got a restaurant opening too, real fast.
Yeah. We have a new Cafe Bernardo opening. It is in the Pavilion Shopping Center at Howe and Fair Oaks.
Awesome.
And we're going to have lots of awesome pastries, including these cookies.
And we'll come down and see you. All right. Thanks so much.
Thank you.